Hello, good morning, dobro jutro, dobrodošli u novu video lekciju prepričavanja na engleskom. Dakle, ovo su video lekcije, ja sam mislim za sve vas koji učite već neko vreme engleski, dakle, to je više neki malo srednji, viši nivo. I u pitanju je pomoć, dakle, vama koji hoćete da počnete da pričate, da se prisetite nekih interesantnih reči, nekih gramatičkih pravila, konstrukcija i fraza koje će vam sigurno zatrebati već u vašem sledećem razgovoru na engleskom. Krećemo. Sentence number one. No, sorry, not today. I have to get up early tomorrow. So, are we going out tonight? No, sorry, not today. I have to get up early tomorrow. Are we going out tonight? No, sorry. Ne, hvala. Not today. Ne danas. I have to get up early tomorrow. Ja moram da ustanem rano sutra. I have to. Have to. Moram. Number two. Are you wondering what we ended up doing? Are you wondering right now, at this moment? Are you thinking about it? Are you wondering what we ended up doing last night? Dakle, are you wondering, present continuous. Znači, da li se sad ti trenutno pitaš šta smo mi na kraju radili? What we ended up doing. So, to end up doing something. Mislim, bukvalno, šta smo završili na kraju radeći? Šta smo radili? What we did. Are you wondering what we did last night? Šta smo radili? Are you wondering what we ended up doing last night? Recimo da je bio plan da idemo u, ne znam, u restoran, but we ended up going to a club. Ali smo na kraju završili tako što smo otišli u klub. So we were planning to go to a restaurant, but we ended up going to this new club. Ok, dakle da je samo malo umesto vi what we did, what we ended up doing, ovo end up, daj samo malo ga začinje, onako što smo na kraju završili radeći. Često se koristi ovo, he ended up in prison, for example, u filmovima, ali na kraju završi u zatvoru i mi tako kažemo, he ended up in prison. Will we be in time for the concert? Will we be? Da li ćemo mi biti in time for the concert, na vreme za taj koncert? So, on time, in time. He came on time, it means he was supposed to come at 8 and he came at 8. Znači, trebalo je da dođe u 8, došao je u 8, to je on time, tačno na vreme. In time, to može znači he was supposed to come at 8, he came at, I don't know, 10 minutes to 8 or 5 minutes to 8. Znači stigao malo earlier, malo ranije, in time, just in time, ali na vreme. Znači on time, u toliko sati, in time, možda malo pre. You'd better stay in bed for a few days. You'd better stay in bed for a few days. Bilo bi bolje. You'd better. Dakle, dajemo savjet. You don't look good. Ne izgledaš dobro. You'd better stay in bed for a few days. You'd better plus infinitive bez to. Dakle, you should. Trebalo bi. You'd better not go to work. You'd better drink some tea. You'd better eat something. You'd better call him, call a doctor immediately. So you'd better. Plus glagol neki obavezno u infinitivu pestu. I plan to get a job as soon as I can. I plan to get a job as soon as I can. Planiram da nađem posao, to find a job, to get a job, da dobijem posao, as soon as I can, čim mogu, što pre. As soon as possible, as soon as I can. Your attention has never belonged to me. Your attention has never belonged to me. Tvoja pažnja nikada nije pripadala meni. Has never belonged to. Znači imamo present perfect sa never. I glagol belong to somebody. So, recimo, hoću da kažem kome pripada ova kuća. Who does this house belong to? Whose is this house? Čija je ova kuća? Who does it belong to? Who does this pencil pen belong to? It belongs to me. It's mine. It belongs to me ili it's mine. Moja je. Okay. So, your attention has never belonged to me. It has never belonged to me. The time passes really quickly. The time passes really quickly. Vreme prolazi veoma brzo. To pass, proći, the time, present simple, treće lice jednine, the time passes really quickly. Does the time pass quickly? Does the time pass quickly? Yes, the time passes quickly. If you'd told me about it earlier, I could have been free. Okay, what's wrong with this? If you'd told me, so if you had told me about it earlier, I could have been free. I could have been free. So, da si mi rekao u vezi sa tim, nešto o tome ranije, mogao sam bukvalno da budem slobodan. Dakle, can you help me? No, I can't help you right now because I have to work. Možeš mi pomogneš? Ne mogu da ti pomognem, moram da radim. But if you had told me about it earlier, I could have been free. Da si mi rekao o tome ranije, mogao bi da ne radim, mogao bi da uzmem slobodan dan. I tako dalje. Dakle, u pitanju je treći kondicional. If plus had plus treća kolona, if you had told me. U drugom delu, would have or could have plus treća kolona. I could have been free. I could have helped you. So, what are we going to talk about? What are we going to talk about? Znači, o čemu ćemo da razgovaramo? To be plus going to plus glagol u infinitivu. Znači, fraza za, u suštini koju koristimo za neku isplaniranu buduću radnju. Znači, o čemu smo planirali da pričamo u tom smislu? Ili o čemu si ti planirao da mi pričamo? So, znači, ti si mene zvao, očigledno na razgovor, znači, what are we going to talk about? O čemu si mislio da ćemo pričati? O čemu ćemo pričati? What are we going to talk about? She bought him a sweater, but he hated the color. She bought him a pullover, a sweater, a jumper, but he hated the color. Kupila mu je džemper, ali bukvalno on je mrzeo boju. So he didn't like the color. He hated it. Ne samo da didn't like it, but hated it. Mrzeo je tu boju. Znači, bought, prošlo vreme od buy. What did she buy him? She bought him a sweater. Did he like it? No, he didn't. He hated the color. What time did you get home last night? Ukoliko sam ti si get home stigao kući sinoć. What time did you get home last night? Come, arrive, get. I got home late. Stigao sam kasno. Or I got home early. Stigao sam rano. Okay, give me a ring as soon as you get home. Give me a ring as soon as you get home. Daj mi prsten čim stigneš kući. Moglo bi to da znači, ali znači pozovi me. Call me, phone me, give me a ring as soon as you get home. Znači to give somebody a ring znači nazvati nekog telefonom as soon as čim you get home ti stigneš kući. Okay, I'll give you a ring as soon as I get home. I will give you a ring. I'll call you as soon as I get home. I'm hungry. I'd like to eat something. I'm hungry. I'd like to eat something. So, gladan sam, ja bih želeo. I want, želim, I'd like to, ja bih želeo. Da nešto pojedem. I'm late for work and my car isn't working. What do I do? I'm late for work and my car isn't working. My car won't start. Neće da mi krene auto. And I'm late for work. Can you give me a lift? Can you give me a lift? Možeš li da me povezaš? To give somebody a lift. To give somebody a ring. Pozvati nekoga, to give somebody a lift, povesti nekoga, auto. I need to find someone to take me to work, or to give me a lift to work. Treba da nađem nekoga ko će me odvesti do posla. I need to find someone to take me to work, or I need to find someone to give me a lift to work. Oh, I forgot my wallet in the car. I'll be right back. I forgot my wallet in the car. I'll be right back. What did you forget? I forgot my wallet. Zaboravio sam novčanik. Where did you forget it? In the car. I forgot my wallet in the car. I'll be right back. Odmah se vraćam. I'll be right back. Odmah se vraćam. The restaurant was crowded and it was hot inside. The restaurant was crowded and hot. So, restoran je bio pun ljudi I bilo je vruće. The restaurant was crowded, the restaurant was hot. And I was hot. I meni je bilo vruće. In that crowded restaurant. U tom prenatrpanom restoranu. So, crowded, pridev, znači puno ljudi. The bus was crowded. And hot, or the plane was crowded and hot. The streets were crowded and it was hot. Crowded. If you're ready, we can start. If you are ready, we can start. Ako si spreman, možemo da počnemo. Are you ready? If you're ready, we can start. I asked my teacher what I should do next, what I should learn next. I asked my teacher, pitao sam nastavnika, what I should do next. Šta bi trebalo sljedeće da uradim? Dakle, indirektno pitanje. Direktno pitanje. Teacher, sorry, what should I do next? What should I do next. Znači modalni pa subjekat pa glavni glagol. What should I do next? What did you ask him? I asked him what I should do next. Znači u tom indirektnom pitanju iza upitne reči odmah prvo subjekat. Što nikad nije slučaj u direktnom pitanju. Znači direktno je what do I do? What did I do? What can I do? What should I do? Znači, ispred subjekta uvek će staviti nešto u direktnom. A indirektno, I asked my teacher what I should do. I asked my teacher what I can do, etc. Let's go out and eat dinner together from time to time. Hajde da izađemo i da večeramo zajedno. Have dinner, eat dinner from time to time, povremeno. You have to come with me. Moraš da pođeš sa mnom. You have to come with me. When is checkout time? When is checkout time? U hotelu recimo. Check in, check out. Kada je checkout? It's something that has been bothering me for some time. This is a good one. That's something that has been bothering me for some time. To je nešto što me je mučilo, što me muči, sorry, neko vreme. Dakle, it has been bothering me, present perfect continuous, znači koji koristimo u situacijama kad je nešto počelo u prošlosti i dalje traje. So, it is bothering me, present continuous, trenutno, it is bothering me, and it has been bothering me for some time. Znači, muči me, mučilo me već neko vrijeme. Present perfect continuous. It's something that has been bothering me for some time. To bother, znači smetati. What are you up to? What are you up to? Znači, what are you doing? Ili šta nameravaš da radiš? Koji su ti planovi? What are you up to? Why did you choose that shirt? Why did you choose that shirt? I chose it because I like it. So choose is obrati. Did you choose? Past simple. I chose it. Izabrao sam je. I chose it because I liked it. Ja mi se dopala. He gathered his composure and he continued to speak. He gathered his composure and he continued to speak. So to gather one's composure znači da se pribrao. To gather je sakupiti. Composure kao stav. He gathered his composure, znači he was nervous or something happened. Nešto dogodilo, he was nervous. But then he gathered his composure and he continued to speak. Znači, pribrao se i nastavio da govori. This is your hat, isn't it? This is your house, isn't it? This is your car, isn't it? This is your pen, isn't it? Znači, ovo je tvoj, u ovom slučaju, hat. Šešir, isn't it, zar ne? I to zar ne, neko nas uvek isto, a anglijskom se uvek menja. U zavisnosti od rečenice ispred. Ovdje imamo this is, znači to be, this is your hat, i to zar ne je isn't it. Ako kažem this was your hat, wasn't it. Dakle, to zar ne, to su question tags, zavise od vremena, glagolskog vremena, od glagola koji je korišćen u ovoj rečenici ispred. You speak English, don't you? For example, ti govoriš engleski, zar ne? You speak English, don't you? Znači, ovdje u ovom slučaju moram da izvučem ovo do, odnosno don't. Nema ga u prvom delu. You speak. Ali znam da je to present simple. I da je odrečeno don't. You don't speak. You speak English, don't you? You spoke English. Govorio si. Didn't you? Zar ne? You spoke English, didn't you? Etc. Question text. If you hadn't had my advice, you would have failed. If you hadn't had my advice, you would have failed. Znači, još jedan treći kondicional. Prvi deo past perfect, drugi deo would have plus treća kolona. Da nisi imao moj savjet, ne bi uspeo. Ili if I hadn't given you my advice, da ti nisam dao, if I hadn't given you my advice, If I hadn't advised you, da te nisam savjetao, you would have failed. You would have failed. To fail znači ne uspeti. Ili you wouldn't have succeeded, ne bi uspeo. I'll be with you as soon as I finish this job. I'll be with you as soon as I finish the job. Znači, bukvalno, bit ću sa tobom čim završim sa ovim poslom, čim završim ovaj posao, odnosno dolazim da se družimo. I'll be with you, dolazim kod tebe. I'll be with you as soon as I finish this job. I'll be with you. And she ignored him almost all day. Ignorisala ga. She didn't want to talk to him. She just ignored him almost all day. Ignorisala ga, ignorisala ga je skoro čitav dan. Okay, that's it for today. See you next time. Ne zaboravite da pritisnete like i subscribe ako vam se video dopao. Goodbye.